I had made this little bias hat on the mid-gauge machine, but what I did was, as I changed the colors, when I was working on the gold, I would take this pinkish color and I would wrap it on the needle, the end needle, every second row, and that caused it to be too tight here. So this is basically going to be for a doll. I don't think it's going to fit a baby because I can't get it to stretch much. But now I'm working up the same hat, one color only. I'm also doing the Quaker stitch. That way there it's going to look a little different. It, not really striped, but if you're going to do stripe, two different color yarns, I would suggest when you attach your second yarn, you're going to take this first yarn, cut it, and weave it up and over the needles. Or you could just weave them in the end when you're done. But if you do it up and over the needles, as you're changing the colors, like I show in another video, that's one less step you have to do in the end. So to do the Quaker stitch, and it's up to you, I'm doing 10 rows. You could do 20 rows if you're working on the standard machine. 20 rows probably going to work out better. And I do use my garter bar. This is for the bulky. But somebody recently just asked me about using the standard garter bar on the bulky machine. And yes, this will work for turning, increase and decrease in. I think when it comes to the lace, when you're using transferring multiple stitches over, it will not work because you cannot push it back behind the gate pegs like you can with the normal one. So, excuse me, if this is all you have, that's just fine. So I bring the needles out. I make sure all the latches are open by pushing the material back. It does do that. And then if you have this old-fashioned one, you make sure those indents are facing up because when you turn it, the hooks go in those indents. And I want to line that up. Now I will, because this is a small one, even if I had my bulky, I usually put the last prong right on the end that the carriage is on. The carriage has to get over to the other side. So I just take my material and pull it onto the garter bar. And as you see, it's working just right, just good. With these garter bars, I tend to go back and forth to close up, open the latches. I lift it off. I take the yarn out of the carriage. Now, I could put the carriage to hold by putting the rustle lever out, or I could even lift the lid up. The only thing is, when I lift the lid up, it tends to bring those stitches back a little bit. And I like to have them out. Now I double check. Okay, the latches are all open. I turn the work around. And I get the hooks on the yarn on that little indent, bring the garter bar down, back around, and pull it through. Then I go ahead and use the garter bar to push the needles back into position, thread my yarn. I do have to put my counter back because I ended at 70. The other thing is, where the first part of this is knit, I want to make sure the last part of this is purl. So this is probably going to be my last section. Now, to continue with the making the bias strip, I see the angle going up here, so I'm going to increase on this side. Now, this way is good because I started out with left to right 15, but when it was the other way around, I went over to left 20, right 10. If you're going to continue doing the bias strip without turning it, depending on, what you like, you could start at the right. Start with casting over here on the right. You're going to increase on the left and decrease on the right. If you start on the left, you're going to increase on the right, decrease on the left. So, actually, I need to decrease, and I'm taking my two-prong transfer tool because I want that one stitch on the end to stay knit. I probably should have used the three-prong, but then I take the one stitch over here and pull it out. Now, normally, I would pick up a bump from the roll before, but I'm not doing that. I'm making eyelets on the side here. This is going to be the top of the hat. So this right here is going to make it less material, not as bulky as I have it on this one here. Although, you know, some people like it that way. And if you like to have your needles out so that they don't drop, that's fine. Of course, now the other thing is I do need to move my claw weights up, especially on this side here. But if I'm going to do that one, I might as well do all three of them. I could have even four on. So now I'm going to knit two rows. Again, I'm going to decrease on the left because I want to keep this the same amount of stitches. I'm increasing on the right. Knit two rows, and I'm going to go up to row 80. Now, I have mentioned this before, but I'm not sure what video it's in, but if I don't have my tension dowel on the yarn mask just right, this end needle is going to be pulled forward. I'm not sure if you could see it, but it's not lined up. And I will just take and pull that back a little bit so that it makes the stitch uniform with the rest of them. And I'll do it on the left here as well. Now, that's good to work on this project because we're going to have to hang one side, in my case, this side over here, to do the rib, whether you're going to use it, have a ribber on your machine to do it, or if you're going to knit, and then reform. But I want to have this edge over here not too loose, but loose enough it's not where it's not tight and pulling in to where it's going to make it hard again on this to, you know, put the ribbon on.